Managed to get you a new one.
Yeah!
But before I give it to you, you have to promise to take better care of him.
Okay.
Better than the ones that you destroyed before.
I promise.
A moon bear for my moon bear.
I'm almost ready, Kathy. Give me 5 minutes to get into my wetsuit.
Don't overdo it, honey. School and work never stops. Just pace yourself.
But I know. I just lost track of time. Plus, the subject matter fascinates.
Father like daughter, I guess. Promise?
Yes. Just 15 minutes from the new campus.
We must have earned a free loyalty relocation at this point.
Lizzie, another one of these seasons and this entire area will be a desert.
Can we just hold off until the kids are done with school and I actually finish a residency for once?
I'm just trying to keep us safe.
Honey, the kids have a dad that commutes to the moon. Safe means something else to them. I want to give them just a bit of normalcy, okay?
Gross!
Mummies and daddies are allowed to do this, I'm afraid.
Breaking news as we go live to the southern border of Colorado in the United States, where fighting has erupted between refugees and border troops. President Van Zandt has denounced the violence, stating that...
Weren't you going to go snorkeling with Claire?
Spectacular dive, honey.
Thanks.
Such an athlete.
I think I pulled something.
Moonbear snorkeling?
Yes.
Claire, please look after her. There's still a lot of debris floating around.
I know, Dad. Don't worry. Come on.
Wait, darling. You're not taking Moonbear into...
Okay, bye, Dad. Love you. Better get us in the water quick before Dad catches you. Come on.
Kathy, what did I say?
But Moonbear wants to go snorkeling too.
Bring me the bear, that you little troublemaker.
No.
I swear, you get this cheekiness from your mother.
Come on, Kathy, jump in.
Can you hear me?
Dad?
It's all right. I'm going to get you out of there now, okay? Come on.
Dad?
It's all right. I'm here. Layla? AC unit 7633-R. Ownership transfer authorization 170544. Isaac Johansson. Say the name, darling.
Kathy Johansson.
Whatever happens, you must keep Ada close to you at all times. Never let her out of your sight, all right?
It's okay. I've got you. Listen, Moonbear, we must be very quiet, okay?
No.
Just listen to me. We have to go.
How are your legs? Can you walk?
Where's Moonbear?
We don't have time for that now, darling.
I want Moonbear.
I think it's somewhere in this room. Be quick.
Found it.
Great. Now come to me. I need your help, Moonbear. There's a button on the other side of the room. When it turns on, I need you to press it, okay?
Okay.
Now, Moonbear. That's it. Okay, it's time to go. Stay low, darling. Don't let them see you. Okay, let's go. Okay, listen carefully, darling. In the room on the other side of the vent up there is Ace.
Rose's Ace?
Yes, we need to take him with us and get him back to her.
Ace likes me best. After Rosa.
Absolutely. That's why I need you to climb up there and call him over to you. Quietly.
Okay.
They're not taking us with them. Don't you see that? They're leaving a physical here. We're...
So they were all planning to abandon Earth?
Let's tell the team we've got the Lunar Council AC in our hands. We need to see more of these holograms.
Ace, it's me. Hi. Follow me.
Number 67354-N. Initiate transfer protocol. Lunar Council override. Isaac Johansson. Code 170544.
Dad, Ace isn't like this.
It's okay. He doesn't know we're taking him back to see Rosa. Isaac Johansson. We've got to hurry. They're probably looking for us now.
Dad, my legs hurt.
Come, I'll carry you.
Dad! That was Claire!
Hey!
Why are you running away?
If Claire catches us,
together. What do you think, Ayla? Reckon we'll get a few more months out of this relic? Yeah, me neither.
Are you done yet? I feel like you should have been done ages ago.
If your butt is starting to hurt from the car seat, you're welcome to come up here and help me.
Huh? No, I'm good. Besides, that wouldn't be much help anyway.
You're right. You wouldn't.
Listen, MPD systems are for nerds.
Okay. Okay, bro. Just be honest. You're feeling too threatened by me and my super brain.
That super brain of yours still needs to be chaperoned to every MPD dish by a senior staff member like me. Remember?
Wait, did you finally admit that you're old?
Whatever.
Anyway, I'm nearly done. Just have to cut out some plating that's obstructing the beam's waveguide. Can you let Moonhub know the dish is ready to receive?
I already did. Don't forget to hook the stream points back up to the receivers.
Mm-hmm. Got it. Now let's get the stream points hooked up, and then we're done. Let me hook up these stream points and I'll be right there. How did people cope before stream tech? Must have been a mess of cables snaking around entire living rooms.
I remember it well. Good times.
Okay, just gotta find the receiver point to connect it to. This is the third site I've had to hook up to a stream point. These dishes shouldn't be running on emergency power.
Yeah, along with everything else in this place.
These smaller cast grain antennae can't withstand another thermal shock. Not with the prolonged power traffic that's passing through them.
You realize no one understands what you're saying, right?
Come on, even you know what a cyclotron wave rectifier is.
Okay, now you're just making up words. Hop on.
Still doing drinks after this?
Claire almost choked me to death last week for giving her beer. Listen, your sister might not be big, but when it's something that concerns you, that woman can kill a lion with her bare hands.
So, that's it. Yes on the drinks. Hello?
Hold on. I got a message that I've been asked to go to Maria right away. Apparently for some classified emergency meeting.
Maria? That's really serious. Can I tag along?
No.
You only have to smuggle me past security, and then once I'm in, I'll just...
No.
Fine.
I know that fine.
Claire? You're going to that meeting at Maria's?
That meeting you're not invited to. Yeah.
Please, Claire, if you just let me through security, just, you know...
I really have to. Perhaps you can phone Monica.
No, I'll just hear about it later. It's fine.
It is. Just let the grown-ups handle this secret meeting first.
Okay. That was uncalled for.
Just wanted to make sure you're not still going to try anything dumb to get in.
I won't.
Don't even think about it.
Uh-huh. All right. Let's go find another way into Maria's office. That's called lying, Ayla. Let's go. Museum. Yeah, we can cut through here to Maria's. Might be fun to have a look around too. Not been here in ages.
In 2041, the lunar MPT dish helped diminish the planet's energy crisis by massively increasing energy yields. After the Great Blackout of 2054 and the instigation of Mission Fortuna, Rolf Robertson made his way to the moon base to restart the MPT, giving his life in the process.
WSA really is trying their best to help our world with our energy needs. I'm sure we'll get to help the entire population someday.
Microwave power technology is a revolutionary form of energy absorption and distribution. The Lunar MPT, along with the 42 Earth-based MPT receivers, helped stop the growing energy crisis of the 2030s.
MPTs, my jam. I got absolutely fascinated by it when I saw my dad working on it every day. He really saved this planet when he designed this.
After the Great Blackout catapulted the Earth back into an energy crisis, Claire Johansson, Maria Gonzalez, and Rolf Robertson undertook Mission Fortuna, a manned rocket mission to discover the blackout's cause. Robertson, under the guise of Johansson and Gonzalez, refueled and reconnected the MPT dish.
Claire really had such a big hand in reviving the WSA.
After the success of Mission Fortuna, Claire Johansson spearheaded Mission Vestia to provide manpower to the Lunar MPT and bring Rolf's body back home. Claire and her team discovered WSA software engineer Sarah Baker critically injured in cryosleep. Isaac Johansson, one of the three Lunar Council members and core outward instigators, took the last arc and escaped.
That's the last time I saw Dad. I'm fine. Just remembering it always feels... I'm fine.
By the Lunar Council members sometime before the Great Blackout, Project Outward saw the evacuation of nearly all Moonbase residents on board three large spacefaring vessels known as ARCs. The location of the traitorous council members, as well as the rest of the Moonbase crew, remains unknown.
My dad designed and built most of the ARCs that they used, like almost everything else here at the WSA. It was supposed to be an escape plan for the colony if something ever went wrong. Ayla, give that door a try and see if we get lucky. Well, worth a try. Oh, hi, Mark. Looking good, sis. They really need to change these. I look nothing like that anymore. Are you joking? You look so good still. Thanks, I try. You? Trying anything? Yeah, right. I meant that, like,
thanks.
You... Never have to
try. Come on, Alex.
Try. Are you headed to Maria's office?
No, why?
Oh, I'm just going the same way, so... Hey, I was just looking at a few of the Mission Fortuna exhibits on my way over here.
That's good.
How long were you actually stationed on the moon?
I was on the space station, mostly.
Ah, right. Yeah, that's why I never saw you on the surface, I guess.
I saw you.
Oh, really?
When I did software upgrades for Rose's ASE.
Oh, yeah, ACE.
No, ASE.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I mean... I named it ACE because I didn't get that ASE was an acronym, so I just kept calling it ACE, and Rosa would just start doing that too. It's kind of a confusing name, I guess.
Right.
Yours is named Alex. right?
Where are you headed to?
Wait, you didn't answer my question yet.
Question?
About how long you were stationed on the moon.
You want the years with the forced cryosleep or without?
Sorry, I didn't mean to.
I really just need to get to the meeting, Kat.
I just wanted to apologize for what happened with my dad. I know he didn't mean what he did. I think that's why he tried to save you on the moon.
Save me? Your dad did not... Kathy, I don't want to be disrespectful, but what your dad and the Lunar Council did, they left us here to rot. They committed the worst crimes imaginable against humankind and our planet. They deserve to be punished for what they've done.
Am I interrupting something?
No?
No.
Thanks to an entire backlog of precedents, I know not to be surprised to see you here.
I made it this far. You might as well just let
no.
me. Maria's gonna be on video.
No.
Okay, I bet you guys rehearsed that.
We totally did.
Run at work.
I like being a rebel. Let's go.
6 years.
What?
On the moon. It was 6 years. I'm sorry I didn't answer your question earlier.
Right. Thanks.
Thank you.
We need line of sight on that conversation area.
Absent. Certain.
So it must be them.
Yes. We feel that we can safely assume that Project Outward sent this signal directly to us, intentionally.
I can't believe it. They're on Mars?
What? Seemingly have been for the last 13 years. Closer than any of us could have imagined.
You okay? Can't imagine this must be easy to hear with everything.
I'm fine. I assume we can finally justify Mission Opera then?
Mission Opera?
Since we pulled Sarah and Kathy from the moon, we've been formulating a contingency plan, should we discover Outward's location.
During Mission Vestia, we found indications that the three ARC vessels Outward used to leave the moon weren't just for transportation. Our information leads us to believe these three ARCs actually form a trine, a completely self-reliant settlement.
But why reach out? Why now? Is it a distress signal or an invitation?
Doesn't matter. Mission Opera has only one objective.
Bring the Arcs and their revolutionary technology back home.
We should analyze the distress signal. Maybe we can determine the encryption used.
We're working on it as we speak. I can enable terminal access in the back office. See what you make of it.
Ada, quick. Find a way inside that room.
Perfect. Ava, stay right there.
What you're about to hear cannot leave this room. Understood?
I'd like to start by including Ryan and Sarah as part of the team. Not only do they excel in their respective fields, they're vital to me personally. I trust them both in my life.
That leaves one more position to be filled.
Yes.
Hey. Hi. At the risk of sounding like an idiot, I think we should take Kathy.
What?
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 She was leagues above the other graduates in our program.
You mean the only class of astronauts that we've had in the past 10 years?
It doesn't change the fact that she aced nearly every exercise, sometimes even doubling my scores. I know you want to keep her out of this, but she's the best MPT engineer we've got. We need her expertise. And look, I will deny ever saying this under oath, I might add. But Kathy's the most talented individual the WSA is working for them. Apart from you two. And me, of course.
We're not seriously discussing this, are we? I mean, she has no prior experience. She's a complete risk to the mission.
Sarah's right. Kathy shouldn't be part of the team. There are too many factors involved.
How do you do this? Hey, Maria. Can I come in, please?
Seriously. Please, Claire, let me be a part of the mission.
Were you eavesdropping?
Yeah, and I'm sorry for that, but Claire, you know I've proven myself to the WSA. 2 concurrent science degrees, majored in stream tech, top marks in the astronaut training program, like Ryan said. Thanks for the kind words, by the way, mate.
Sure.
And you need my MPT expertise. Please, Claire, with you by my side, I know I can do this. We can do this.
Plus, there's only, like, what, 3 other trained astronauts to choose from, so...
I think you should take her on the team, Claire.
What?
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 Nice.
She's one of the most qualified people we have at the WSA. However, the final say is yours, of course.
Okay, Kathy. Even though Ryan's last argument was severely lacking, yeah.
Ouch.
I believe you'll do everything you can to guarantee the mission's success. Right, Kat?
Of course.
Now I would like to go over the minutiae for the mission with Claire, Sarah, and Ryan. Can you let us handle this without listening in this time?
Oh, well, seeing as I'm now...
Kathy.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah. Of course. You all snug in there, Ayla? You need anything? Cup of coffee? Magazine? You diva.
You look nervous.
And that amuses you?
No. Just seeing you, you're proud.
Hey, that scar on Sarah's stomach, is that the one Dad gave her?
Yeah, why?
Just curious.
Knock, knock. You ready? Let's go.
Yeah?
GC, we're heading to the rocket now.
Copy that. Transport is ready for you.
How's everyone feeling?
Good. Slept like a baby.
Of course you did.
You didn't?
Yeah. Sure.
How about you two?
Good.
Yeah, fine.
Good.
Go.
No turning back.
Nope.
Hey.
happy. You know what I still think about?
What?
How come we get to live in better conditions than the people in the shanty town? How is that possible?
Pure probability. Geographically and demographically, we were born in the right place at the right time. They weren't so lucky.
Right. Oh, they really don't seem to want us to go.
No. But considering the amount of time...
Whoa. You okay?
Yeah, just a bit startled.
Are they insane? They're not helping anyone by trying to hurt us. Don't they understand that we're doing this to save them?
Those people will be on the MPT waiting list until the day that they die. You saw the WSA using so many resources to send 4 people to space? You'd be angry too.
They don't understand. But when we bring the Arcs back, they will.
Or they won't. I mean, they might, and I hope they do, but we're promising something that might not happen, even if we do bring back the Arcs.
Hope springs eternal in the human breast. It's the way I choose to view it.
Alexander Pope. The soul, uneasy and confined from home, dreams of a life to come.
Look at you knowing your poetry.
What can I say? I'm not just a pretty face.
Okay.
Take a look at this view.
Wow.
Never ceases to amaze, right? Shame we couldn't build her properly.
What?
With all the shortages of materials, it really is a miracle that this thing is here at all.
You could have mentioned this in all these months of prep that we're flying economy class.
No, I didn't want to worry you.
Except for right before we're taking off.
Seemed only fair to disclose it now.
Sure, sure.
If Claire believes we can use her for the mission, we should trust her.
I believe Zephyr 3 will handle the mission just fine.
Launch sequence initiated.
Opera team, this is ground control. Proceed with final checks.
Copy, GC. Opera team, comms check. Go.
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 Cat, systems check. Oxygen?
Oxygen is go.
Flight?
Flight is go.
Navigation?
Navigation is go.
Ground launch sequencer?
Ground launch sequencer is go.
Fuel?
Fuel is go.
Liquid oxygen?
Liquid oxygen is go.
Power?
Power is go.
Launch sequence functions?
Launch sequence functions are go.
Propellant load check? Good to go. Brian, airtight seal and cockpit air composition check?
Seal and air composition are go.
Sarah, start fuel cell thermal conditioning.
Conditioning is a go.
Cat, strong back retract.
Strong back successfully retracted.
Sarah, bent off lines.
Lines are vented. We are go.
Starting automatic ground launch sequencer. Sequencer is a go. Cat, retract orbiter access arm.
Orbiter access arm is retracted.
Copy. Start auxiliary power unit.
Auxiliary power units are go.
Copy. Retract gaseous oxygen vent arm.
Cap retracted.
Opera team, visors down.
Go. Go.
Go.
Go.
Cap, we're to transfer from ground to internal power.
Transfer complete. We're on internal power. Thrusters are a go.
Copy. Thrusters up. We are going for launch.
Here we go.
Lift off. Number 3, this is ground control. Birds in the air, all of the green.
Go.
Copy. Initiate second stage ignition.
Go.
And it's away.
Here we go, Opera Team. The journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step.
Babe, did you prepare philosophical quotes for the entire journey, or...?
Only like 5 a day.
Oh, good.
Wanna see something cool? Maybe I made skateboards.
You didn't like it?
I mean, it's great, truly.
One small step was already taken, so...
Oh, wow, old school, huh?
Yeah.
Excited. You never look excited.
Don't be cheeky. I was as frugal as possible when designing this ship. However, I did splurge on one last-minute addition.
A window.
You're really ruining the moment.
Sorry.
Just look. This is what we're doing it for. Right, Kath?
Sarah and Ryan are probably settling into their pod. I'll head back to the cockpit.
Be right there.
You heard that too, right?
Yes. I'm in the cockpit checking the diagnostics. Meet me here?
Sure.
I need eyes on to determine the damage. I'll perform an EVA and let you know, GC.
Copy.
Did the thruster get hit?
Probably. Could you keep an eye on the diagnostics? I'll get ready.
Wait. Let me do it. Look, I need real-life experience out there. Of all the EVAs we could have, this one is pretty safe, right? I mean, I could just casually mention my stellar extravehicular activities training score.
No, it's fine. I think
it was 94.
Mine was 95.
See, you're so much better with numbers. Best you monitor the diagnostics.
Fine. Just be very careful. We're still in orbit, so watch out for debris.
Got it.
Get prepped at the airlock, and I'll guide you on comms.
If you find yourself drifting, use your thrusters to correct, and quickly double-check the latch of your left nozzle controller.
I've double-checked it, Claire. I'm fine.
I don't think you really double-checked.
Claire, I've got this.
All right. Egress out of the airlock.
Oh.
what's all this from, anyway?
Satellites, mission-related debris, even pieces from Sarah's old station.
Pearson Space Station? From when Rolf survived the breach during the moon mission? I'm kind of honored.
What a weird thing to feel honored about. Right, first things first, what can you see? Is there any damage to the thruster?
There's a huge bit of debris stuck in the thruster. Could be from the space station.
Okay. Is the plating around the base of the thruster damaged?
It's seen better days, but it's holding together.
Good. What about the pipes around the thruster?
They're pretty badly bent.
Okay. They'll need to be cut away if we want the thruster to be even semi-functional. Is the thruster still receiving power?
It is.
Shut off the power lines before you do anything else. There's a big button in the hatch, just press it, and you're good to go.
Okay.
And watch out for the fuel canisters. If you hit one of those while you're cutting it... Well, don't, please.
What do they look like?
The big yellow canisters. Do you see them?
I see them. Don't worry, I'll be careful.
Very careful.
Very careful.
Okay. Turn the power off and begin the debris removal.
Ever take you swimming there when you were young?
He did, but not when I was that young.
What do you mean?
Well, never mind. So, anybody fancy back home?
Wait, what?
Or maybe even on the ship.
What? Ryan?
Oh, there are, I don't care.
Apparently not. Least of all that they're married.
You can still have feelings for someone despite the circumstances. I don't know, with everything that's going on with the world.
done.
Okay, good job. Turn the power back on, and I'll run a diagnostic.
On it. Power's back on.
Running diagnostic now. And we're good. Okay. Great job, Cal. Head back inside. Carefully.
Yes. Yes, Claire.
Girl.
What now?
What was that?
Same thruster.
How bad is it?
Bad, sis.
One broken thruster could send us completely off course. I'll suit up.
Let me do it. I'm already out of torpor.
No, it's much too dangerous.
Claire, we have to act fast. I'm going.
Please be careful.
Copy.
Sis, I don't think we can salvage this thruster. It's taking severe damage.
Diagnostics say the same. You'll have to cut it away.
Are you sure?
In this state, it's a bigger liability if it stays attached to the ship.
Copy.
Turn the power off before you do.
Claire, I can't turn the power off from here.
Okay. You need to cut the power cable connected to the thruster. You can't miss it.
I'm through. Power is off.
Right, now the tricky part. You need to cut the thruster from the ship. Slow and steady.
Copy. One of the thruster canisters and it blew me back. I'm okay. I'm gonna cut the rest of the thruster away now.
I should have gone out there.
I'm fine, Claire. Don't worry.
forest feels denser now, compared to a few years ago at least.
That's impossible, unfortunately.
I know. That's why I said feels. And it still looks beautiful.
It used to look even more beautiful.
And it can become more beautiful again someday.
Maybe. Maybe.
Are you okay?
I just haven't been here in a while, that's all.
You look sad.
No, I'm fine. I'm glad we get to spend some time together before you have to leave.
Girls, we're almost there. Let's keep walking.
Come on. Let's go.
Are you going to finish the story?
Right, yeah, where was I? Ah, right, okay, so her mum was visiting one of her friends at a frat party that night.
What's a frat party?
Well, it's like a birthday party, but instead of presents, people just, drink a lot.
That sounds stupid.
It was. I never liked going to those either. But I'm glad I did go to this one. Your mum saw me staring at her so much that she finally came up and asked me why I wasn't dancing.
Why weren't you?
Well, you've seen me dance. I told her that getting me to dance was a bad idea, and, well, I was proven right.
What happened?
I hit her drink out of her hands as I was flailing about like a lunatic. Then a piece of the broken glass got lodged in her leg. Then there was blood everywhere, and then we had to go to the emergency room.
Oh, Jesus, Dad.
Needless to say, I didn't dance again until our wedding day.
But, Dad, why did Mummy fall in love with you then?
I really have no idea, darling.
Whoa.
Cool, right?
Who made this?
Dad.
Glad this is all still here. Claire and I used to come climbing here all the time.
Why didn't I get to go?
Well, you were a bit too young for that.
Still are.
Okay, Moonbear, come and get your gear. Final checks to commence mission. Lightfoot. So, this is like the climbing wall at home. Except this time you get to use these cool-looking claw things. Leftfoot. If you make it to the top of the cork wall, you are one step closer to the moon.
Dad?
Yeah?
Are there a lot of walls to climb on the moon?
No. But to get to the moon, you need a badge. Just like your scouting badges, basically.
Why do I need a climbing badge?
Well, it's a badge that on our journey to the moon, were we to make an emergency landing, we needed to climb our way out, you could, and then you'd find your way home.
Can something go wrong with the rocket?
No, they're perfectly well built. Isn't that right, Claire?
They're completely safe, Kathy. I promise.
All right, so, final tally. Go or no go?
Go.
Just slamming each pickaxe as hard as you can, one after the other. You can do it, Moonbear!
I made it!
Amazing, Moonbear! We're going to the moon! Excited?
Yay!
Okay. Carefully climb down now, okay, Rimbert? You should know exactly how well built they are.
I will rephrase. How do you justify the risks of taking Kathy to live on the moon versus her just staying here on Earth?
You know what is happening to our planet. Have you forgotten? You read the same WMO reports that I do. You watch the same news. You know what happened.
I hate you for what you're doing. I hate you.
Come on. Let's put the gear away.
Why doesn't Claire want to go with us?
She does. Don't worry. Change your mind.
And we'll be together?
Yep. Let's get you home. You need a big rest before your exam tomorrow.
You've been watching me sleep?
Yes.
That's kind of creepy, sis.
I just brought that for comfort.
What do you expect to find on Mars, Kat?
Nothing.
I understand what you're thinking, I think. But sometimes what we want isn't... It's always difficult to do the right thing, and I really believe Isaac always meant well.
Isaac? You mean Dad?
Dad always meant well. I just need you to understand he was not always good at doing the right thing. Right.
Well, at least he always tries to do the right thing.
Right.
Well, that's all that matters, right? He's always looked out for us. He couldn't help what happened.
Yeah, you're right.
It's not weird for me to want to find him, is it?
I need to know that when we get there, you'll make the right decisions.
Claire? Kathy? Come meet us in the cockpit.
Kat.
I said I'd do what's best for the mission. So far, I'm doing just that. Right?
I closed the shutters for dramatic effect, because what's in front of us will amaze, shock, and possibly delight you. What? I know Outward's the bad guy, but you can't deny how impressive it is what they built.
Okay. You just shouldn't glorify them, that's all.
Okay. Well, that might have put a bit of a damper on this, but... Opera team, I give you... Arc Labos.
Would you look at that?
Seen solar panels like these?
Looks like they combine standard PV panels with a sort of CSP layering over it.
Excuse you?
It appears these panels first concentrate the solar rays to optimization before they hit the photovoltaic semiconductors. The increase to efficiency is exponential. How could they be so far ahead of us?
And why does it look abandoned?
Let's find out. Sarah, Ryan, suit up and prepare to board. Kathy, start the pre-docking preparations.
I'm doing the docking procedure.
Yes, you're staying aboard the Zephyr with me. Now please start the procedure. All right, Ryan and Sarah, prepare to board. Supervise the procedure on this terminal.
Okay.
Kathy, CMG and pit controls are released and available for manual control.
On it.
Waypoint 0 to 2 are calculated and defined. Waypoint 2 assigned to auto lock abort function. Final go, no go pilot waypoint 2. All right, Kathy, take us in.
One reached. Commence maneuver to waypoint 2. Roger that. Slow it down, Cat. Reaching final waypoint. Starting final soft capture procedure. Final poll.
Go.
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 Roger. Kathy, you got this.
Hard capture now also complete. Docking confirmed.
Looks like a smooth dock. Great job, Kathy.
Thanks.
Ryan, Sarah, you have permission to enter the ship.
Permission was assumed. We're already crossing as we speak.
Copy. I'll reprimand you later for insubordination.
I shall accept my sentence with dignity.
Sis, I can join them to investigate. We only need one person.
That's not necessary.
It's not necessary for me to stay here either.
Kathy, please respect my command.
You're my sister.
I am your commander.
Claire, I think we could use another set of eyes over here. The interior is huge and built like a maze. We could be here a while.
Copy, Sarah. Kathy's heading over now.
Copy that. Hey, beautiful. Is it this quiet everywhere inside the ship?
From what I've seen so far, yeah.
This makes it a defense rather than an accident.
Hmm. Ayla, are you seeing this? I've never seen so many cryopods in one place before. A hologram? Here? How are you even finding this data? Are you keeping secrets from me, Ayla? Well, let's take a look.
People to help me. I'm not that old.
Wait. Rosa?
You can let go of me. I'm not going to do anything.
Sorry, Miss Laferte, but Director MacArthur was clear.
Outwardians, welcome to a new dawn. We stand on the edge of greatness. We are the culmination of thousands of years of technological progress. Earth is a lost cause. There's no coming back from the damage we inflicted upon her. But now, we have a chance to correct humanity's course. A future without conflict, without division, uncorrupted by weakness or doubt. We have the tools, the minds, and the bodies to create a sustainable utopia. A place for you, your future children and grandchildren. With my 5-year plan, we will build a solid foundation for Outward together.
What about Arc Vita?
Don't we need all 3 arcs for this to work?
The loss of Arc Vita is one we can overcome if we remain strong and work hard to compensate. But for this to succeed, we must be unified. If we do not work together, we will fail. If we challenge and fight one another, we will fail. In this monumental endeavor, we are only as strong as our weakest link. So, people of Outward, we stand on the precipice. Join me, and together we will build something better. Gather your belongings and prepare to transfer to Ark Habitus for our descent to Mars. We leave in 2 hours. Was that stunt truly necessary? What were you hoping to achieve by diverting the ship? Rosa, I don't want to force you to cooperate, but...
Tell that to the fine men you've got escorting me.
I'm sorry it came to this, but we need you. Outward needs you. Your medical expertise is crucial to the colony. Everyone's lives depend on it.
I will do my best.
Thank you.
I'm not doing it for you, William.
Rosa and the others. Ayla, if they made it to the surface, they could be with Dad right now. Ayla, I'll log these to my astro tool myself. So go ahead and strike them from your backups, okay? We'll let the others know later. After we find out. Rosa and the others. Ayla, if they made it to the surface, they could be with Dad right now. Ayla, I'll log these to my astro tool myself. So go ahead and strike them from your backups, okay? We'll let the other...
Guys, I found the Ark solar energy transformer. These panels are reaching 90%
What? The best solar panels we've produced in the past 20 years can't even reach 40. So why isn't it functional?
Well, that's the weird part. It is functional. It just seems they turn it off. Strange.
Make a note of this. The door to the bridge is locked, but I think I can open it with a stream point.
Copy that. Keep us posted.
I should be able to connect this through the glass. Through.
Great job, Kathy. Yes, now press onto the bridge.
Claire, I'm in the bridge and the entire room is filled with pieces of debris.
You sound almost happy.
Well, to be honest, the chaos looks very... pretty.
Easy there, Edgelord.
Can you determine what caused it?
I'll look around. The emergency security doors have been activated here.
That means the area behind that door had a hull breach.
So is this ship deserted because the crew got sucked into space?
Seems plausible. Perhaps it was an accident after all.
Whatever happened behind those closed doors is the answer.
An answer we can't get to.
No, afraid not. Looks like I need to fix the MPT converters before I can turn the ARC's power back on.
Output metrics show the same. The MPT dish isn't receiving any of the energy from the batteries.
This ship's operating system is really locked tight, but I think this should open up a door behind you, right? Now, Kathy, finding a way to restore the ARC's power is top priority.
I'm on it.
I will. Everybody on high alert. Final go, no go, Paul. Go.
Go.
Go. Thanks. Let me double check. What a mess. The breach really did a number on this place, too.
Thank you.
All right. Great. Thanks. I think that did it. Opera team, Arc Larbos is fully functional.
Congratulations, team. One arc down, two to go.
Let's check the MPT, Ayla. Claire, the MPT is fully operational again. I'm going to re-establish the connection to the surf.
No!
What? Roger that.
Entry guidance design has been re-optimized. Preparing for EDL.
T-minus 2 minutes to cruise stage separation. Everybody copy?
Copy.
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 I'm sorry for being so protective. I know I'm not Mum. What I mean is...
I see how much you've grown. I know I can trust you. Thanks.
Commander.
Moment of truth, Opera Team. If the orbit burn doesn't function, we all know what to do.
Starting burn.
Nominal velocity changes, propulsive efficiency completely tanked.
Unable to correct.
What about tertiary thrusters?
Gone. Momentum desaturation has failed, mass expulsion won't help. We are in loss of control.
Understood. Opera team, abandon ship. Brian, Sarah, to cargo in the pods. Kathy and I will try one last maneuver. Kat, do you copy?
Thank you. 8,000 meters to surface. Pod exceeding optimum velocity.
receiving this? Did you make it? Sarah? Ryan? Sarah.